नंबर फोर इन आवर मेजरमेंट लैब हेडिंग इज द टू ऑब्जर्व द वेरिएशन ऑफ वोल्टेज अक्रॉस ईच स्टार कनेक्टेड अनबैलेंस लोड विथ एंड विदाउट प्रेजेंस ऑफ न्यूट्रल वायर। इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी विल सी एंड वी विल ऑब्जर्व द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द न्यूट्रल वायर। सो फर्स्ट वी विल सी दिस इज द बेसिक सर्किट डायग्राम ऑफ दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड हियर दिस इज द थ्री फेज बैलेंस सप्लाई वी विल अप्लाई टू दिस ऑटो ट्रांसफॉर्मर। दिस इज थ्री फेज ऑटो ट्रांसफॉर्मर एंड द फेज सिक्वेंस ऑफ दिस सप्लाई इज द आर वाई एंड वी। नाउ आफ्टर दिस ऑटो ट्रांसफॉर्मर एंड वी कनेक्ट दिस आर फेज टू वन एमीटर। दिस इज मूविंग आयरन टाइप ऑफ एमीटर एंड अनोदर टर्मिनल ऑफ दिस एमीटर टू कनेक्टेड टू द आर फेज ऑफ दिस लोड। दिस इज थ्री फेज लोड। वी विल सी हियर फर्स्ट टेक वी विल टेक द वैलेंस कंडीशन एंड अनोदर वी विल टेक द अनवैलेंस कंडीशन। तो दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी विल कंप्लीटेड इन द टू केसेज। फर्स्ट इन द केस वन वी विल ऑब्जर्व एंड वी विल सी द इफेक्ट ऑफ न्यूट्रल वायर इन द वैलेंस कंडीशन एंड इन अनोदर इन वी विल सी द इफेक्ट ऑफ न्यूट्रल वायर इन द अनवैलेंस कंडीशन। दिस इज मूविंग आयरन टाइप ऑफ वोल्ट मीटर रेटिंग इज 0 to 600 volt connected between this R and Y phase. So this voltmeter will give the reading of line voltage VRY and this Y phase connected to the Y phase of the balance load and this B phase to connected to the B phase of this load. And another is that most important thing here, the neutral of this auto transformer connected to this neutral of this load by using a switch. Another is that there are a moving iron type of ammeter. This is the A2 ammeter and rating of this A2 ammeter is 0 to 2 ampere. This is moving iron or moving iron type. And here this is switch. We will connect between both these neutral of the load and the auto transformer. This is three phase balance supply to apply this auto transformer. This is three phase auto transformer. Here we will see this is the R phase, this is the Y phase, and this is the blue phase. And below this blue phase, this is the neutral terminal of this auto transformer. So we will see the connection one by one. So R phase and Y phase, this is the Y phase. We will connect a voltmeter between R and Y phase. So see, this is the we are connecting a moving iron type of voltmeter rating 0 to 600 volt. See, this is the moving iron type of voltmeter. This is the rating 600 volt connected between R and Y phase. See, this is the R phase. This R phase connected to this terminal. This is connected in the parallel between R and Y. This is the Y phase. Another terminal of this voltmeter connected to this Y phase. Another, this is the R terminal of this auto transformer connected to the ammeter. Rating is 0 to 5 ampere. See here. This is the moving iron type of voltmeter connected between R and Y. And this is the ammeter connected in this series of this R phase. So one terminal of this moving iron type of ammeter connected to the R phase of this auto transformer and another terminal of this moving iron type of ammeter connected to the R phase of this three phase load. This is the R phase of three phase load. This is the resistive load bank. See the nameplate of this resistive load. 415 volt 7 ampere load and this is the switch. We will make some on connection and applied maximum 7 ampere we can apply here. And this is the neutral terminal of this three phase load and this is the R phase, this is the Y phase and this is the V phase. To make a star connection we will connect all the terminal together by using these wires for making the star connection of this load. This is the biphase of this auto transformer connected to the biphase of this resistive load. And B phase of this auto transformer connected by using this blue wire to the resistive load, blue phase of the resistive load. Now finally, this is the neutral terminal of this auto transformer. This neutral terminal first connected to this moving iron type of ammeter. See here. So we will make a connection between both the neutral terminal by using this moving iron type of ammeter. The range of this moving iron type of ammeter is 0 to 2 ampere. It will see the neutral wire current, and the another terminal of this ammeter connected to the one terminal of the switch. This is the switch. And finally, the output terminal of this switch connected to the neutral terminal of this load, resistive load. This is the neutral, connected together by using this wire and connected to this switch. So this is finally, this is the overall experimental setup. See, this experiment will be completed into two cases. In first case one, we will take a balanced load and neutral wire switch is closed. This is the neutral wire switch. In the first case, this is closed and load is balanced. See, this is the neutral wire switch. In the first case, the neutral wire switch will be closed and this load is balanced. Balanced load means that the resistance of all these phase R by B will be equal. First, we will measure all these resistance by using this multimeter. We will measuring all these resistance and we will make a balanced load here. Yeah, first we will measure all these resistance by using this multimeter. And this is the R phase and this is the neutral terminal. Now we are going to check this three phase load is balanced or unbalanced. So we are checking by the measuring the resistance of the R phase, Y phase, B phase. First we are measuring the resistance of this R phase. So just see the reading of the R phase. This is the around 58.9 ohm. This is the resistance of the R phase. Now this is the Y phase. The resistance of this Y phase is 58 ohm around. This is the nearly equal to R phase. And this is the B phase. The resistance of this B phase is also equal to 57.5, around near equal to 58 ohm. So this is the balance load, three phase balance load, and this is the case one. Now we will making the connection and we'll go for the experiment. I am going to give the three phase balance supply to this three phase auto transformer. This is the switch, just switch on, and this is the knob of this auto transformer. Just slightly we vary this knob and we can vary the voltage. See the reading of the voltmeter. This is the voltmeter. We will apply here the rated voltage up to 415 volt by varying this knob. See the reading. Now just more vary this knob. Now we can see this is the 415 volt. Okay. Now you can see also the reading of this R phase. This is the load current in this R phase. This is around up to 4.1 ampere, 4.01 around. This is the current of this R phase. Now we are going to see the reading of this ammeter 2, which are connected between both the neutral terminal of the auto transformer and the three phase balance supply. So see, this is the ammeter which are connected in both the neutral terminal. This is the switch is closed, and here this ammeter show the reading is 0. This is the 0 ampere. So this is indicating load is balanced. Because of balanced load, the no current flowing to this neutral wire. So this ammeter show the reading is 0 ampere. Now by using this multimeter, just set this multimeter at the point of the AC voltage, and we will verify the all these per phase voltage must be equal in the balance condition. So first we will measure the voltage of the R phase. This is the R phase, and we will see the reading of this per phase voltage of R phase around 235.4, around 235.5. Now we will see the per phase voltage of this Y phase. This is the Y phase. See the reading. This is also 239 volt. This is around 238. This is around equal to the 235. And now we will see the per phase voltage of this B phase. This is also around 235.7. So all these per phase voltage nearly equal in the balance condition. So in this case one, when the balance load applied and the switch is closed, so in this case the per phase voltage of R phase nearly equal to Y phase and nearly equal to V phase around 236 volt. In this case the current flow to this neutral wire we will measuring by this ammeter 2 is equal to 0, and all these phase voltage of VR and VY and VB nearly approximate equal to 236 volt. In this case one, this is the switch is closed. Now we will see the effect when the switch is open. Switch is open and load is balanced. So first we will switch is open. Now I am going to open the switch. This is the switch. Now both the neutral terminal isolated. They are not connected to each other. This is the neutral terminal. Both are isolated and not connected to each other. Now we bearing this knob and applied the rated voltage here, and we will see in the effect when the neutral terminal is open. We will apply here 415 volt around. And there must be the line voltage must be equal to in this previous case. Okay. Now we will see the reading of the per phase voltage at the load terminal. This is the line voltage we applied. And this is the current of this R phase around 4.1 ampere. And previous case also the current is the same in this R phase. Now we are going to measuring the per phase voltage of this resistive load. First this is the R phase, and we are measuring to the phase voltage of this R phase. This is around equal to 237 volt, and this is the Y phase, and the reading of the per phase voltage of this Y phase around 236.5 volt, and this is the B phase, and the reading, the voltage reading of this B phase is the 236 around. So the conclusion is that when the neutral is isolated and neutral is connected, in both these cases the per phase voltage are nearly equal. So in this case also the per phase voltage around 235.5 nearly equal to 236 volt. See here. इन दिस कंडीशन बैलेंस लोड एंड स्विच इज ओपन, तो पर फेज वोल्टेज वी आर वी वाई एंड वी वी ऑल दिस वोल्टेज आर नियरली इक्वल टू 236 वोल्ट. सो इन बोथ द केसेज द पर फेज वोल्टेज इज नियरली इक्वल. हियर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द अनबैलेंस लोड. सो इन दिस प्रीवियस केस दिस इज द बैलेंस लोड एंड इन दिस प्रीवियस केस द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ आर फेज इज इक्वल टू रेजिस्टेंस इन द वाई फेज इज इक्वल टू रेजिस्टेंस इन द बी फेज. फॉर मेकिंग दिस अनबैलेंस इन द प्रीवियस बैलेंस लोड वी एड ए अनोदर एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस इन दिस आर फेज. सी हियर दिस इज द एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस बाय यूजिंग द रियोस्टेट वी विल एड हियर. एंड नाउ इन दिस केस द टोटल रेजिस्टेंस इन दिस आर फेज दिस इज कॉल्ड द आर आर डैश इज इक्वल टू आर एक्सटर्नल प्लस आर आर. ओके नाउ वी विल सी इन द सर्किट हाउ वी विल एड द एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस एंड व्हाट इज द रेजिस्टेंस वी विल एड हियर. सो प्रीवियसली वी यूज दिस इज द बैलेंस लोड एंड हियर वी कैन सी द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस आर फेज दिस इज इक्वल टू 57 ओम अराउंड नियरली इक्वल टू 57.7 ओम एंड दिस इज द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द वाई फेज अराउंड 57 ओम एंड दिस इज द रेजिस्टेंस इन द बी फेज आल्सो अराउंड 57 ओम. सो द ऑल द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ इन द आर फेज वाई फेज एंड बी फेज आर इक्वल इन दिस बैलेंस लोड. नाउ सी हियर दिस इज द एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस एंड दिस एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस वी विल कनेक्ट इन दिस आर फेज. सी इन दिस सर्किट डायग्राम दिस एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस वी विल एड इन दिस आर फेज. सो दिस इज द एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस एंड वन टर्मिनल ऑफ दिस एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस कनेक्टेड टू द सेकेंड टर्मिनल ऑफ दिस एमीटर. सो सी हियर दिस इज द एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड टर्मिनल ऑफ दिस एमीटर एंड वी विल कनेक्ट हियर इन दिस एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस. बिफोर कनेक्टिंग वी विल मेजर व्हाट इज द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस हियर बाय यूजिंग दिस मल्टीमीटर. फर्स्ट वी विल मेजर द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस. सी द रीडिंग इन दिस मल्टीमीटर दिस इज अराउंड 17.3 ओम एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो वेरी दिस रेजिस्टेंस बाय यूजिंग दिस नॉब. नाउ सी हियर द रीडिंग अराउंड 20.61 ओम वी हैव एडेड द रेजिस्टेंस इन दिस आर फेज. सो नाउ इन दिस प्रीवियस द रेजिस्टेंस इन दिस आर फेज इज 57 ओम एंड वी हैव एडेड द एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस वैल्यू इज द 20.7 ओम एंड आफ्टर एडिंग द टोटल रेजिस्टेंस इन आर फेज इज इक्वल टू 77.7 ओम एंड रेजिस्टेंस इन दिस आर फेज सी हियर बाय यूजिंग दिस वायर एंड दिस इज द आर फेज. नाउ वी विल वेरीफाई द रेजिस्टेंस बाय यूजिंग दिस मल्टीमीटर एंड वी कैन कैलकुलेट दिस रेजिस्टेंस हियर दिस इज द आर फेज एंड दिस इज द न्यूट्रल टर्मिनल. सो पुट वन टर्मिनल ऑफ दिस मल्टीमीटर एट द न्यूट्रल एंड अनोदर इज द अपर टर्मिनल ऑफ दिस आर एक्सटर्नल एंड वी कैन सी वाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस टोटल रेजिस्टेंस इन दिस आर फेज. सी दिस इज द वन टर्मिनल वी हैव पुट हियर एंड दिस अनोदर वी हैव पुट इन दिस न्यूट्रल. टोटल रेजिस्टेंस इज अराउंड 77.7 ओम नियरली इक्वल टू 78.4 ओम. सी हियर the previously calculation the total resistance around 77.7 ohm and after we measure the resistance also nearly equal to 78 ohm. So now see here, so first we will see in this unbalancing load first we will take the case switch is closed and after switching closed we will see the reading in this ammeter which are connected between both the neutral of the load and the neutral of this auto transformer. This is the ammeter reading. So unbalancing condition we will see what is the response of this ammeter. There are some current flow through the neutral of the load to the neutral of this auto transformer.
Okay, first we will switch on the supply and we will apply here rated voltage. This is the switch we have on and we vary the knob slowly and we will apply the rated voltage up to 415 volt. Now you will see the reading of this ammeter of neutral. There are some current flow in this neutral. The current flow from neutral terminal of the load to the supply of this neutral, see here, and the magnitude of this current depend on the level of unbalancing. See here, the voltage is around 415 volt. And the current in this R phase around 3.1 ampere and current in this neutral wire is equal to 1.1 ampere. See the reading. This is the current flowing in this neutral terminal, neutral wires, 1.1 ampere. Now we will measure the phase voltage in this unbalancing condition when switch is closed. First we will see the voltage across the R terminal. See here the value in this, by using this multimeter we will measure the voltage. This is the voltage in this R phase, 235.6, around 236 value. Now we will measure the voltage across this Y terminal. The value is around 237, nearly equal to in the previous voltage. Now we will see the voltage across the B terminal. It is also 235 around. So we have seen that when switch is closed, the all these phase voltage are nearly equal to 236 volt. And also in this balancing condition, these voltage will also be equal. See here. So in this unbalancing condition, the voltage across R phase is equal to Y phase is equal to V phase, nearly equal to 236 volt. And also in this previous case, in this balancing load, this voltage is also nearly equal to 236 volt. So when we close the switch of the neutral terminal, there are some current flow through neutral wire and the magnitude of this and neutral current depending the level of unbalancing. Now this is the part 2 of the second case. First we will open this switch. After this open this switch, the both the neutral is isolated and there are no current flow through this ammeter because we have already opened the switch. And we will see what is the happened and what happened across this phase voltage. The phase voltage will be equal or not equal, we will see here. First we will apply the supply by using this switch and slowly we vary this knob of this auto transformer and we will apply the line voltage equal to 415 volt, and we will also see the reading of this ammeter because already the switch is closed, so no reading in this ammeter, no current flow through this neutral wire, and see the line voltage around 415 volt. And we will see what happened and what is the value of the phase voltage in that condition, in the unbalancing condition. The line voltage is nearly equal to 415 volt. And this is the current in this R phase around 3.3 ampere. Okay. Now we will see what is the phase voltage of this across the R phase. So by using this multimeter we will measure the phase voltage across this R phase. See the reading. This is equal to 257 volt in this unbalancing condition. So VR is equal to 257 volt. Okay. Now the voltage across this Y terminal. This is the 223.5 volt. We have clearly see here the voltage across the Y phase not equal to voltage across the R phase, because now in that case the resistance across this R phase are not equal to resistance across the Y and V phase. so both voltages are not nearly not equal, and also we will measure the voltage of across the B phase. The across the B phase voltage is equal to 222.8 ohm. Okay, so we have seen here the neutral terminal is isolated and switch is open. So why, when we switch is open, so the voltages are not equal to each other in that case by using this unbalancing condition. So in this case R phase voltage is very high to compare to Y phase and B phase voltage. So now we conclude that when we applied the balance load, so we don't need any neutral wire. So in this balancing condition, when all current and their power factor are the same, the phasor sum of all line current is equal to zero. This is the reason why there is no need for neutral wire in the balance condition. Now in an unbalanced three phase electrical load, the line current are different, which cause the neutral current to flow from the star point of the load to the supply star point. If the neutral wire is broken or disconnected, the out of balanced current cannot return to the supply through the star point, but it must return. So this current takes the path back to the supply through the lines. Ideally, the star point should be at 0 volt, and that is the case when the neutral wire is intact, but when it's broken and because the current are forced to return via lines, this point shifts to a different voltage. When the neutral wire is isolated, the voltage at the star point is not equal to at 0 volt. So there are some potential difference created between both these neutral terminals, and we will see how much the potential difference by using this multimeter. We will measure the voltage across both the neutral terminal. Switch which are, we will connect the both the neutral. Put one terminal as this is the one terminal of the switch, and another this the second terminal of the switch, and see the voltage here. So in the previous case, the potential difference between both these neutral is 0 volt. Now in this unbalancing condition, this is voltage equal to near 25.5 volt. So the higher this voltage, because there are some potential difference created and the value is very higher, this higher is the risk of electric shock to a person, and this can be very dangerous. Thank you.